I'm Mary Portas.
Mary, Mary, why you bugging?
Over a year ago, I took on an enormous challenge.
There is another lot.
Turning charity shops from has-beens...
Is that a potty in there?
..into a shopper's dream.
Are you ready to sell? Yes!
The change was not easy.
This is the sort of crap you get at the end of a car boot sale.
And nor was it enough.
It's not like the old days.
Bloody good job it's not like the old days.
So now I'm returning to the charity world. I've unfinished business.
The biggest issue is people volunteering. So to me, getting volunteers is absolutely crucial.
Oh, there they all are.
I'm going to overhaul the volunteer army.
How do you feel about having more youth?
Yes,
especially men.
But it means a radical new approach.
We're doing V-Day, which means you can drop in to any of the charity shops on the back,
okay,
and give a few hours. You gonna sign up?
No.
You are a control freak.
You know what? We're not finished yet.
Mary, Mary.
It all started over a year ago, and recession was biting. Charity shop sales should have been skyrocketing, but they were not.
I think that charity shops have the real, real potential to offer good value fashion to people shopping on a budget. You know, not only that, charity shopping is much better than most clothes ending up in landfill. But at the moment, there's only a few devotees who actually shop charity shops. And I want to change that.
I convinced a large charity to hand over one of their worst performing shops. It was taking £900 per week. They wanted me to make that £2,000 per week.
In order for me to understand how charity shops work, I need to get under the skin of it, and therefore I am going to be managing my own charity shop.
My shop was in Orpington, Kent. I was about to see it for the very first time.
Where's my shop? There's me. Save the children. God save me.
I'd never worked in charity retail, so before I took it over, I arranged to go back to the floor and work as a volunteer for the day.
Oh, this is her. I recognise her.
Hello.
Hello.
Welcome to Save the Children Fund, Orpington.
Hello, and you are?
Jean.
Jean.
Yes.
Is this your shop? Are you in charge?
No.
God, right. OK, then who is? Who's in charge?
Nobody.
Nobody?
No. We're all volunteers, and at the moment we don't have a shop leader.
Okay.
Do you want to take your jacket
Hello,
off?
Hello, I'm Mary.
No, this is Graham.
Graham, hi.
Yes.
You know, I'll take my jacket.
We hang our coats in here, Mary.
My shop had 35 unpaid volunteers, just like Jean and Graham. And I wondered how on earth they ran the shop with no one person in charge.
Who says, right, these are the jobs that need to be done today?
We just slot in. We slot in.
We normally consult one another.
No,
you know, that's right.
Okay.
This all sounded very amicable, but I didn't think the democratic approach was necessarily working wonders for the shop floor. It was a mess.
This is a little bric-a-brac, really, and people coming in always look here.
OK, now we're in the fashion department.
Yes.
Oh, mind you, it's got some crockery up the back there.
Oh, yeah.
So
yes, this is still bric-a-brac.
So the fashion with bric-a-brac, that works, does it?
Yes, yeah, okay. It's a case of where there's room in the shop.
I would guess that is the case.
Yes.
Is that a potty in there? Is that someone's potty?
I couldn't imagine anyone buying anything off those shelves, and hidden out the back were the two volunteers responsible for choosing it.
Who's that coming out the back door? So can I meet the back room
Yes.
girls?
We can hear you in here.
Hello, I'm Mary.
This is Iris.
And I'm Mary.
No.
Iris and Mary had been doing one day a week here for over 20 years. I joined them on sorting duty to see if I could find any hidden gems for the shop floor.
Where's my workspace? There's no space to tip it out.
Well, we put it onto the floor because there could be things like used needles or something really dirty and grotty and not nice, moist.
What's moist? What do you get that's moist in a bag?
Just imagine something that could be moist. Underclothes.
Oh, but I can't even think about
it's
it.
It's true. So sanitary towels and Durex and all sorts of things.
My husband thinks I wear gloves.
Right.
But it's easier not to.
I'm just astounded on two levels. First of all, what rubbish people have just brought in there. I mean, actually, I would say 70% of what's in that back room is just utter rubbish. And then the other bit of these women who have given up their lives. I mean, we're talking 30 years, 38 years. Before I left for the night, the shop's area manager, Nick Piggott, came in to see me.
Nick.
Mary, good afternoon. Lovely to meet you.
Nice to meet
Hello.
You.
From the following day, his problems would become mine. It just seems a bit like Paddy's Market in a lovely way, in a kind of social gathering for these old women. And if they make some money, it just seems, well, you know, that's a bonus.
Every shop is extremely individual. Every shop has its little ways. Every shop has...
Yeah, but it shouldn't have its little ways. Do you know what I mean? That's the problem I've got. Yeah. Jean having her little ways, Iris having her little ways, and I know they're volunteers. Yeah. I understand that. But it is about saying to them, this is what we need to achieve. This is how much money we need to make. This is how we believe we can do it. Are you all on board, you know? And I think they're crying out for that, Nick. That's what I feel. OK, well, I'll tell you what you could actually start with. Do you live locally?
No, not desperately, no. Sorry.
Could you wash my little Save the Children? Do you have a washing machine at home?
I do have a washing machine at home.
Thanks very much, because that smells. And that would be nice. I'd feel good if I put on one that was clean in the morning.
I can probably get you a brand new one if you want.
No, it's OK. Just wash that one. Brilliant. The next day, I took over. My shop's £900 per week takings were pitiful for a high street store. I wanted to prove that by acting like a professional retailer, profits would rocket.
Good God.
I called a meeting to kickstart my revolution.
Hello.
And I was going to meet every member of my volunteer sales team.
Hi, ladies.
Hello.
Morning.
Hello.
Irene, hi.
Marion, please meet
you. Marion.
We do the toys and we've been doing them for over 40 years.
Well, morning and thank you for being here on time.
I'm here to help. Truthfully, this business isn't making as much money as it could do, OK? We need to clean up the act and we need to get some retail standards in here. So the first thing I want to do today is I want to re-merchandise the shop. So it's going to be a big job, all hands on deck. We're going to set up a proper system out the back because if you think that's the heart of the business coming through.
Oh, I 100% agree with you, Mary. I've been keen to rearrange it for the last year. And as June will tell you, we've met some fierce resistance.
Yes. Who's fierce resistance from? Who are the fierce resistance?
People who've been here a very long time. And don't want change, I'm afraid.
Well, you know what? Today, change happens.
Fantastic.
OK? On one hand, you don't want to patronise, you know? And on the other hand, they're in another world. They're in another world. With my army of OAPs, I was determined to get this shop into better shape. Most retailers put their best sellers near the front door. Clothes should have been our biggest money spinner, so we planned to move the bric-a-brac to the back and have a fashion section up front.
I need to change the mannequins in the windows. Will you choose something fabulous?
No, you choose it.
I'm starting to lose the will. I was beginning to realise that getting things done here would be much harder than I was used to. They do their own thing. Just do their own thing. Go into their little comfort zone.
Everybody else a sandwich?
I can't see what we're going to achieve by it, really. Do you, Jean? What can
yes.
we achieve?
Well, we shall have more space.
Yeah.
We won't have all this junk. And everything that comes in now will go out quicker.
Hopefully, yeah.
If I was to hit my £2,000 target, I had to be selling decent fashion.
Ali Baba's pants. Mm.
Who's Paul Hosey?
Problem was, I couldn't find any.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
This is the sort of crap you get at the end of a car boot sale. I'm worried I've got to take money on this. This is my next week's takings.
Although my new layout was getting there, I didn't stand a chance of hitting my new target if I was relying on donations like this. One day in and I realised my problems were much bigger than changing the shop's layout. I had no stock worth selling.
Completely and utterly astounded at how bad the merchandise, well, actually not merchandise, that would be too polite and too fabulous a word for it, but the crap that gets landed in the Orpington shop.
I wanted to know just how bad this problem was, so I decided to find out if other charity shops were suffering too. I arranged to meet Chris, the manager of a mental health charity shop in West Wickham.
Hello.
Hi.
Who's Christine?
She's hiding.
Hi, Christine.
Hello.
I'm Mary.
Nice to meet you, Mary.
You too.
Welcome.
Tell me, what percentage of stuff that you get donated are you able to sell?
I would say quarter.
Oh, stop it.
No.
That's outrageous.
I'll show you.
Chris and Caroline very kindly put aside some of the treasures they had donated over the past month.
Underneath.
Hang on, no, 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 stop don't it. Touch. Look, we've got a gadget, Mary. There you are, like, if you want to. Okay, red bag.
I don't agree with that this is someone thinking they're doing good.
We are. No, look at the colour of that bra.
See, look, we're all girls together here, Mary. How long did you have to wear a bra for it to go like that? You know what I mean?
Dirty little... That has gone as hard as
a nice
an old crust bread.
Isn't it? I don't even know what it is. Oh, it's a jacket.
Jesus, it's crusted up.
This is what we call galloping neck rot. Oh, is this the terminal flatulence? Oh. You see, you have to laugh, really, because you...
You're right,
Mary,
you would.
You? Oh, what is that?
What?
Oh,
God, that's a punch. Oh, no more, Chris. No more.
Have
I can't.
Had enough?
What would you want me to do? If I'm really giving and can make a difference to charity, what would you want from this?
It's get people to take a second look in their bags
make
before
aware,
they...
Make people aware, innit?
Yeah.
Aware of what we need. And what
load up your black bag, but then tip it out and have a second look.
The quality of donations was abysmal across the board. I wanted to make it my mission to help solve the problem for every charity out there. But whilst I came up with a plan, I had my own shop to run. And I needed to find out what my geriatric workforce was capable of. To go from veteran tea drinkers to bringing in £2,000 a week, they had to become a dynamic sales team.
Do you know, per head, mm-hmm. how much each of you take a week in?
30?
30 would be good! 30 would be great, Iris!
Taking
in you're taking
like
£12.50.
No!
Oh, yeah. No. Now remember the model? They wouldn't get out of bed for less than 10,000?
Yes,
you
yes.
lot are getting out for £12.50. Come on, you lot. It's like, I feel like the school teacher. Come on, are we all together now?
If Brenda and the gang were to boost sales, they could no longer just turn up for work. Like any good sales team, they needed to be motivated to sell. As there was nothing exciting to sell from the shop, I hired a market stall, bought 400 cupcakes, and gave the volunteers half a day to shift them.
These are the favourite cakes of Madonna and Kate Moss.
Oh, wow.
Oh, wow.
That's
so
I wouldn't buy anything like that. You don't know where they've been made, and they're out in the dust. Nothing covered up, are they?
Okay. Well, do you know what, darling? We do know where they've been made. You're going to have to believe in this, my darling, because you are going to have to sell these.
Yes.
No.
It was time to see what my grey army could do.
Please buy a cake. Please buy a cake.
Be on a bigger voice. Come on, Graham, you've got to make
£1.50 each. It's the best bargain today here.
It's so interesting because you start to see the different characters. So this is where you really start to understand the people who are going to come to the front and really energise and deliver your business.
Which one would you like? There's the one with that big spider on there, look. Oh, that big spider.
Whilst ex-football coach Graham had hit his stride, one of my ladies was doing anything to avoid making a sale.
Brenda, what are you doing with that belt?
I don't know.
Time is of the essence. Get on that stool. Have you ever gone outside your comfort zone, Brenda?
Yes, I have, yeah.
Have you? When was that, darling?
Oh, I can't remember now.
Come on.
We've got no gloves, we've got no tongs to pick them up.
Well, look, you thought I'll show you this. Come on. Brenda's not taken part. She's just turned away and kind of like... It's slightly embarrassed about this. Every issue, they're not undercover. Where are the gloves? You've got gloves. Moan, moan, moan. So are you finding this tough?
No.
You don't like it that much, though?
No.
Why don't you like it? Do you like? Do you prefer being back room than out the front?
I do.
You're quite shy deep down.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Are you a shy little shrinking violet? Hey Brenda. Next person approaching is me and you. Come on, Brenda. Tell her whose favourite cakes they are. You don't want to do it?
No.
These are favoured by Madonna and Kate Moss, these cakes.
Ooh. Have that one, please. And one of these.
Cakes! Thank you very much. Have a good day. Thank you.
If Brenda didn't overcome her nerves, she'd stay hiding in the back room forever. I thought she was a bit embarrassed, so I sent everyone for lunch while she gave it a go.
Oh, 1, 2, 1.
Has he seen? Has he seen?
And a coffee one, please.
There's another one, Brenda. You can't help it now.
Two cute. He wants the little blue one.
Oh, the little blue one. That's lovely.
Stuff it in her face.
10 minutes. How much do you reckon you've taken?
I reckon I've got £20. Yeah.
Fantastic. Probably. Fantastic. How does that make you feel, then?
I'm shaking.
Shaking with joy or shaking?
And it's your fault. You told them to go.
Once they start to see people buying it, just gives them confidence. So that's what it's about. That's what selling is about.
It took a fair bit of pushing, but by the end of the day, we'd taken over £550. All of it for charity.
Well done. All of you have been unbelievable. One thing's really important, guys. This is about us going back and giving this energy back into the shop.
But afterward, I turned to the biggest problem facing every charity shop, those sacks of terrible donations. 3/4 of what came in was simply not good enough to put out on the shop floor. I'd been racking my brains, and I'd come up with an idea. People usually gave to charity when they were clearing out old junk. I wanted people to treat donating like giving us a gift, so we'd get items of real value. I needed to get this message out to people with great clothes to give. British Gas headquarters was near my shop, and I convinced them to let me loose in their offices.
Here I'm guessing the vast Middle England blue chip company workers. And I need to get into their psyche, give back, then at least I've got a chance of getting some decent merchandise into that shop.
British Gas.
I asked my trusty volunteers, Graham, Brenda and Rita, to help me.
I need people like you, who are all smartly dressed, to donate. I want you to look in your homes and I want you to donate things that you believe will have a minimum resale value of £5. Otherwise, it's just not worth it.
There were 800 well-dressed workers in these offices.
Do you give anything to charity shops?
No, I don't.
Right. Well, at least you're being honest, you know. I think some people go...
Far too lazy.
Are you?
Yeah.
So what do you do with it?
Right away.
What do you normally do with them then?
I probably put them in my dustbin bag.
Where to? Where does he chuck it?
Well, it's not into a charity shop, that's for sure. Talking to those guys up there, they just dump their stuff. They wouldn't dream of going to a charity shop at all to even give, certainly not to shop. I have to understand the different mindsets. I'm just wanting us to look at decent donations, you know?
Music stuff as well, music, CDs, videos.
And jewelry.
I really hoped we'd convince them to buy into this. I was coming back in a week to collect what I hoped would be top-notch donations.
We don't get good quality goods from somewhere like this.
Yeah. Well, then
it is a little bit of a problem, then, isn't it? Where will we get them from?
Yeah, I mean, a lot of these are young people and they've got nice clothes, and if they don't wear them anymore, we'll give them to us, isn't it?
But as well as donations, I was beginning to think about my fabulous sales team. Most of the volunteers at charity shops are pensioners.
Lady interested in the dress shirt in the window. Oh, it's a shirt, isn't it? Not a dress.
Mine had an average age of 72.
But they're not earrings, surely.
They were committed.
Yeah, look, they are.
Oh, yeah.
But they were out of touch with the stock and shops of today.
Why would I have a bin in the bloody window?
As time went on, I realised this was going to hold the shop back.
I am just going to have this reversing back to its old ways. We're going to get nowhere. And it needs a leader to do that. I'm happy to be the leader, set those standards, but you need someone who's going to maintain them.
I thought the solution was to put in a professional shop manager, but that was going to take money, so I set out for head office to ask for it.
Can you tell me the reasoning behind not having a manager in there?
It's a huge overhead cost to us.
What I need in there is someone who's patrolling the people and what goes on and what the practice is, that takes responsibility. Yeah.
I'm not sure whether employing a paid shop manager in Orpington is necessarily going to give us the best return.
I believe that you could practically double the takings that you're doing in there.
If we did, we'd have to. If we put a paid manager in, we would have to at least double those takings. Because for us, this is about returning as much money to save the children as we can.
If you don't start investing in some real training and some management in those shops, then I believe you're going to be left behind. I genuinely do believe that. I worry where your future will be.
She's a lot to learn. It's not like a normal standard retail business. It's very different. She's going into a poor performing shop and we want to see some absolute significant growth.
Anyone running a retail chain or a retail shop that's not in the charity sector wouldn't even think twice about putting a shop manager in there. Of course, the minute the shop manager goes, they panic, you know, who's the next one? Who's been trained up? Who's the deputy manager? Who are the supervisors? So even having this discussion is slightly bizarre.
While the debate about shop managers rumbled on, I returned to British Gas to see if my hunt for better donations would be met with more enthusiasm. I'd been trying to crack the problem of dire stock, not just for my shop, but for all charity shops. So I was desperate for my idea of asking people to donate one or two quality items to work. I had Jean and my old favourite Brenda at my side.
Let's bring in your goodies.
We've got a pretty little handbag here.
Oh, that's
gorgeous. That's sweet. Oh, I've seen. Got some jewellery inside it as well.
She put jewellery in it.
Oh, my goodness. We have queues, won't we? Yes.
Rather.
Yeah. Hello.
Hello.
Hello, darling.
Hello.
Oh, my God. I've got a lot of stuff. Sorry.
What? No, don't say sorry. That's fantastic.
Oh!
Isn't that fabulous?
Yes.
You little star. Oh, my God, we've got a Dunhill tie.
Mary, this is the designer.
This is designer man. Paul Smith hat and a Dunhill tie. When was the last time you saw Paul Smith or Dunhill in your shop?
I don't know if it happened, actually.
You don't know if you had. Are you a star? Thank you. Bless you for doing that.
Someone passed the smelling salts. I had something designer to sell in my shop.
Does it feel good?
Yeah, because they've only just got into the bin, basically, so that's fine, yeah. So if someone's going to benefit from it, that's brilliant.
It was my first major success, and this was an approach that might just work for other charities.
See? You believe it now, don't you, when you see this?
Yes, it's amazing. It really is amazing, isn't it?
We haven't got any rubbish at all.
No, no. Everything will go like gold. Yes.
It's a relief. It's an incredible relief. You know, because this is exhausting. There's no easy fix on this. You know, you are reliant on every aspect. Everything's out of your hands. It's such a big task. But this has made me just feel, thank God it's worked. But I think it's a great little idea, it's a great concept. We can now roll this out.
I had the stock, but my shop still looked like a flea pit. To attract serious shoppers, we had to look like a serious retailer. Head office had agreed to invest £15,000 in a refit. and also to my request to recruit a new paid shop manager, Josephine. All on the promise I would raise income to £2,000 a week. I convinced Jane Lawrence from internationally renowned Conran Design, famous for iconic high street store Habitat, to put together new plans.
Hey.
Mary.
Oh, she comes laden with boards. Hi, darling.
Hi, how are you?
It was a big morning for the Voles. I was unveiling my vision and they'd also meet their new boss.
Two people with me today, Josephine and Jane. Hi. And Jo is joining as shop manager. So these are your motley crew. And Jane has joined us from Conran Design. And she will talk through our designs for the new shop fit.
I'm going to start by... Good afternoon, everybody. The first thing...
I wanted this shop to have the vibrant feel of a marketplace, not just to be another fashion shop. This was where charity shops could stand out and play to their strengths.
We're introducing pegboard, which is very versatile. We're introducing lino.
Cold to stand on.
Cold to stand on. We're not asking you to put your bare feet on
now. No, I know, but the carpets are much...
Carpets are much warmer.
More comfortable to stand on.
Well, in your slippers.
Yeah.
Have you considered stiletto damage?
That is it's totally incredibly hard, hard.
I'm going to test it.
I'm going to test it.
Jump up and down.
Yeah. Well, who's going to be jumping up and down? Who's going to be on must buy in here? All right, how's that take it?
Absolutely.
Not even a mark. Well done, Jane. I've never had the clap from them.
Thank you very much.
I was beginning to realise that the old guard might struggle to move with the times.
I think it's going to take a while for it. Their heads to get round it. And I guess because I'm so used to working a very fast-paced retail business, and so all my every day of my life I'm looking at consumers, selling, shopping, consumer. So to me it just feels, right, well, here's another great idea. And they're all like that. A little bit shell-shocked.
With the refit looming, we were holding a clearance sale. But as my plans to modernise sunk in, the volunteers were rebelling.
It's all expense, isn't it? With the refit, it's going to cost a lot of money, and with the manageress, that's costing money. So we've got to try harder to make more money each week, haven't we?
Well, as I've just come back from Kosovo and Albania and been delivering aid there and seen poverty, then you do begin to wonder. Another 15,000 could do a lot more than just paint a shop and change a carpet.
Has it been a nightmare?
Well, one of the regular volunteers has handed in a notice.
Who was that?
That was Doreen.
Why she handed it in just...
Well, she said that she doesn't agree with all the money spent. She said it's ridiculous. She said we could have just washed the walls and washed the carpet and relaid it.
This was really worrying, because in any business, resignations can affect staff morale. To make it worse, the volunteer who resigned was the sister-in-law of Brenda, and I really didn't want to lose her support.
What do you think a real reason is? Do you really think it's...
It is. It's because of what you're doing and spending the money. And she said, we are slogging our guts out to get money for this shop, and it's being spent. I can see her point. I can see her point. And now we're going to have new flooring. Why?
Oh, you need it. We'll need it. We do need to make this better, Brenda. I know you think it'll just stay the same, but we can't get this shop to make more money by leaving it with those dodgy old fixtures and stained grey floors. We just can't do it. It needs an update. It needs it, and this is the cheapest that I can do it.
And then if you put your prices up, people are going to come in and say, oh, we've got to pay for what's been done.
Oh, do you know what? I'm trying to be clever with the budgets, and the only spend that I'm doing is on the store design. It's the only spend I'm doing, and I've got someone who's resigned over it. You know what? I can sit and cry, but I can't. I've got work to do, and I need to get on with this shop, and we'll just have to find someone who replaces her.
A week later, and the builders moved in, and the shop that had been reassuringly familiar to the volunteers since Princess Anne opened it 20 years ago would never look the same again. Whilst my shop was being transformed, I wanted to help other charity shops too. So I took the chance to spread the word about my new donation initiative to three other charities, including my old friend Chris from Mind.
We've exhausted all the traditional avenues of getting donated stock, so we've got to do something new.
Good afternoon, ladies. Fingers crossed they'd like my idea, which I'd now given a name.
D-Day, Donate Don't Dump Day, I want to be a regular date in the calendar.
It was an idea that worked brilliantly for my shop at British Gas. Now I wanted these ladies to do the same.
What I want you to think about is being proactive sales teams who are going out and saying, we need this from you. We need this from you. We need this from you.
D-Day is vital. They need to spread that word and they need to spread it with passion and energy.
So we got cracking.
Get your boobs in that one then, Chris, OK?
They had some eye-catching promotional material.
Oh, I don't like it.
And I'd lined up some blue-chip companies willing to donate.
Oh, no, it's a man! More menswear! After me! Oh, that looks interesting, yes.
I think we have a wonderful turnout. I really think it was worth it. And I would love to do it again, really.
D-Day was a wonderful idea. I'm only cross that I didn't think of it myself.
Our shop, we're definitely going to go back and look at the map and find some other companies.
I'd finally found a way to improve the quality of donations, not just for these ladies and their shops, but just maybe for every charity out there.
Come on. Thank you so much, really.
In Orpington, my shop's transformation was now complete. And it looked fantastic. I'd renamed it a living and giving shop. And for the first time, like any great store, the merchandise was displayed in distinct areas. With our latest fantastic donations, this place now looked like a shopaholic's dream. Well, I thought so.
First impression?
Yeah.
I know. Dark and drab, yeah, the black, yeah. Yeah, look at that wall there, look, with the black on it. And the black floor. No. What?
I think. Man.
Hello, Orpington. Are you ready to sell?
Yes.
Yay! Louder, are you ready to sell?
Yes!
Thank you, guys. Open your door. Let's get the business in. Well done. Are you ready to sell? Come in, come in. Hello. Hello. There's some great kid stuff and fashion right up the back, but don't lose mummy.
Despite the old guard's reaction, thankfully, the shoppers seem to love it. Though I was beginning to think my volunteers might need more than a shop manager to transform them.
Joe, they might need help on the till here. Maybe they should have a swap round.
What's really great was that customers were giving their verdict by spending.
Can you empty your pin, please, dear?
I mean, my big role is to get Save the Children rolling this out so that other charity businesses can go, blimey, that really is a clever business model that is making good money. We should be on that boat. All right, we're going to have a go. Come on.
All right, can we shut the door?
Yeah, let's shut the door.
Hey, Jane, what we got?
£957.
Oh, man! In 2 hours.
That's your week's taking. Well, we'll have to put this away, dear.
Let's celebrate for a second, shall we? Yeah. Let's let the information. She's like, look, where's the help? We're all cashing up. 900, what was it again?
57 pounds, 36 pence.
Well done, two hours.
Can I ring Brenda up when you let her know?
Yeah, I think we'd better be.
Brenda, O.Ye of little faith.
Yes.
What was she like this morning? You ring her up, you spread the word, and if any of them go, it's not going to work, you remind them how much we took.
Yes.
Yeah?
Performing on launch day is fine, but sustaining sales was the real challenge. Over the following month, the charity monitored takings, and Jane from head office and regional manager Nick were finally ready to give me the results.
Since we reopened after the refit, it's been pretty phenomenal.
It's been fantastic. It's been a dramatic success. Yeah. It really has.
Absolutely phenomenal. Absolute success. You've achieved your target of £2,000 a week, so well done. Brilliant.
I think we can categorically say a success. I think we can, yeah, definitely. I mean, the challenge is now for us to maintain it, you know, without you. Take it forward and take it on. It's going to be great. It really is.
We have a new charity business. We have a new charity business.
That was 6 months ago. Since then, my charity has begun to roll out my new shop ideas across their chain, and D-Day has been picked up by over 40 charities around the country. But now I'm heading back, because I'm not done yet. There's one problem still facing all charities, and it's one I struggled with at my shop.
And the biggest issue after donations is people volunteering. They just do not have the staff. If you do not have the staff, it limits you. It not only limits you in selling, it limits you in finding new product, it limits you in merchandising your shop. So to me, getting volunteers is absolutely crucial. I didn't have time to do that last time. I had too many other big tasks. This is the next one.
The volunteer workforce in charity shops is aging fast. The average age of a high street shop assistant is 36, but the majority in charity shops are nearly double that. We need more new blood coming in, and I've got an idea that I want to try out. So I'm going to my old shop in Orpington to see what they think of it.
Oh, there they all are! Hello. Hi, ladies! Hello. How are you?
Great!
Are you good?
Yeah, fine.
Brenda, are you still moaning about it being dark in here?
I'm not moaning, but I still don't like it. It's too dark.
Well,
it's not for me to say, is it?
No! Since when has it never been for you to say anything? Right. Just tell me, what's been your turnover?
About £2,500.
Yeah.
So it's pretty much tripled.
Sometimes it's up. Sometimes it's even higher than that.
Yeah, well, that's on average. We've gone as high as nearly four. It's been amazing.
So I've proved my old ideas worked. But will they buy into my new one?
OK, guys, can we all gather around for a meeting? You thought I wasn't ever going to do this again. Come on, Brenda, stop hiding behind there, would you? So, first of all, I have to tell you how brilliant I think the shop is. But we're not finished yet. Now I need to do the final part of the jigsaw. We need more volunteers. New and younger volunteers, OK? How do you feel about having more youth?
Oh, love it.
Yes.
Especially men. We're all girls.
Yes. So we want some
young men. Oh, young men.
Normally, charity shops insist on regular commitment from their volunteers. I want to change that.
I think it's important that we don't limit them to having to come in 2 afternoons a week or 2 mornings a week, because most people can't do that today.
Well, do you mean that they could just come in at odd times? They don't have to make it a regular thing?
Yes. When you have to commit straight away, it's very difficult to do that. It's a bit like a relationship, you know? When you meet a new man, Lila, you know, you don't say straight away, should we get married, do you?
Yes, we do!
It's just coming in for the odd hour.
A few hours. I want people to be able to say, you know what, I've got some spare time on that day. I've got an afternoon or I've got a morning. I might not know a week beforehand what day that's going to be, but I will volunteer my time.
To see if my idea will work, I want to trial a drop-in day next week.
So instead of it being D-Day, we now have V-Day! Right? Well done, guys, OK? Yeah. V-Day, and it's going to be volunteer day. So will I have your support on that?
Yes.
Yes, that was a really loud. Yes.
I was hoping for a bit more enthusiasm.
With reservations, I think it would be a good idea.
I'm not overly sure about it all, but we'll see. Proof is in the pudding.
I'm always prepared to try something, and then if it doesn't work, we just forget about it.
I don't mind. I don't mind them coming. I don't mind them coming as long as they work.
Let's remember, when these women have been coming day in, day out for 40 years, doing the same shift at the same time, invariably in the same position in the shop, when you throw something on them and say, right, people are just going to turn up, their first response was, how's that going to work? So I think there's an air of, I'm not sure, but I think they're behind me.
Orpington is just the start. To really test my drop-in volunteer idea, I need to go big. I want to get 20 shops on board.
Hi, good afternoon.
I've arranged to meet top brass from some of the nation's biggest charities.
Yeah, how's business? Is it going well? Come on in, let's get together.
But as yet, they don't know why.
I want to initiate a volunteer action programme. You know I did D-Day, I now want to do V-Day, volunteer day. Okay? But not only to increase the level of volunteers, I feel quite strongly that I also want to get younger volunteers into the retail shops. Do you agree with me on that?
Anything that attracts younger people to our shops would be wonderful.
The average age for the sector is well over 55.
How well over?
I would say probably closer to 65.
Right. Now, I'm going to talk you through it, and I want the V. The V, you will notice, is the right way round. If I don't get many volunteers, it could be the other way round. And this is realistically us going out to get more volunteers. And I want the only rule to be is that they are passionate and they turn up and they want to give their time. But whatever time they can give. So realistically, I'm talking about drop-in staff. How does that sound to you, Help the Aged?
Some of the issues you're going to have are issues around training. What are the people going to come in and do? They can't use the till unless they've been used to train the till. They can't steam clothes unless they've been trained to use the steamers.
They are problems, but they're not insurmountable. And you can train someone to use the till quite quickly, or to process stock, or to tidy rails.
I think it would be difficult for the shop managers because it actually gives them more work.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yes. But I've got to persuade them. Yes. I want to try this idea in just a few days.
I want one day where I can get these volunteers turning up, okay, to the shops. And in order to do that, I will need, between your charities, about 20 shops in order to do that. Is that possible? Who's behind me on V-Day? A vote of hands. Well,
they're prepared to lend me their shops, but they're not that confident my idea will work.
Look, nothing's easy until you start actioning it. And I think what was interesting is they were right. The biggest issue isn't, funnily enough, from them, it's going to be the managers in the shops, because they're the ones who are going to have to handle this daily.
My shops are scattered across London. They're helping publicise the V-Day trial. Now I need to get moving to find my 50 drop-in volunteers. And I've got a campaign plan to get the word out across the capital.
So today is my big volunteer push. I need to fill 20 shops with new volunteers. So it's not going to be easy, it's not going to be straightforward. I have no high expectations, but I'm damn well going to try.
I'm going on a major radio station heard by over 500,000 young Londoners with my nervous partner in crime, Brenda. although she doesn't know it yet.
I haven't told Brenda why I've asked her here today. I've just got her up here, because if I did tell Brenda, she wouldn't arrive.
Come on, Brenda. Good morning. In you come. In you come.
Right, now, do you know why I brought you down here?
No.
I need to get the word out there, and we want to get new volunteers in London. So we're going to go on air and ask for volunteers, OK? And they're going to talk to you about volunteering. No. Brenda, yes. Yes, you'll be fine. I'll be with you, OK? They will probably ask you why you volunteered. What do you think you'd say to that?
Well, I didn't volunteer.
Right, that's helpful. Yeah. So that's a great answer first off, Brenda. Yeah, let's make this really easy.
Because my sister-in-law asked me to come. So yes, I didn't. But
that's volunteering still, darling.
Yeah, it is.
And what do you love about volunteering?
Well, what do I say? I don't know.
I mean, do you socialise with any of the people in the shop? You know, do you?
No.
Right, OK. Well, it's going to be a great interview.
Yes.
You'll be a star. Come on, let's go through. Let's meet him.
Brenda needs to make volunteering cool and attractive to younger people. I hope I've picked the right person.
Right, are we ready?
Yeah,
rock and roll!
OK, Mary, first of all, explain to us exactly what's happening on Friday. What is V-Day?
V-Day means you can drop in and you can do whatever time you have available to volunteer.
Now, how do you think that younger people are going to cope with working in a charity shop? Because there are all sorts of preconceptions, aren't there?
I don't know about youngsters. Sometimes you can't rely on the youngsters to come in. You think they're going to come in one day and they don't...
Poor Brenda's getting the wrong end of the stick.
You can more or less rely on those.
So
what we're asking is for some of the youngsters to come in and rely on them, you know?
Yeah.
Perfect. Lovely. Thanks for that.
Did she attract young volunteers? She was saying that they were rubbish.
I think it went great. Yeah. I was pleased with it. Yeah. I was.
Well, thankfully, our radio plug isn't my only idea. I've called on my volunteer army to help in a big hitting publicity stunt in Oxford Street, London's busiest shopping location. As many as 500,000 people pass this window every day.
Come on, ladies, I've got a little window to show you. Right. This is our promotional window, OK? This is the window that we'll be promoting V-Day, Volunteer Day.
I styled up my volunteer army into living mannequins.
I want you to be right at the front like that, OK?
We've got two volunteers from London Hospice, and dear old Brenda, who's loving the limelight now. And they're already pulling a crowd.
Fantastic, ladies. Okay, right. This is the launch of V-Day. Volunteer, I need some new models. I want you to volunteer today to come and work in the charity shops, okay?
Whilst my beautiful mannequins attract the crowds, me and the rest of the volunteers try to sign them up.
We need some volunteers in our charity shop. So we're doing V-Day, which means you can drop in to any of the charity shops on the back.
Okay.
In a few hours.
But it isn't going to be easy. We need at least 50 people, and we've got about 2 hours before the shops shut to get them.
Anybody else? Can we interest you, sweetheart, in volunteering?
No.
You're going to sign up? No. Bugger off if you're going to muck about. Anybody will sign up.
And as predicted, one of the veteran shop managers isn't convinced by the idea either.
My doubts are that when you're running a busy business, it's not always beneficial to have people just wandering in and out, volunteers just wandering in and out as they feel like it. Sometimes it can use my time trying to find them something to do. We'll see what happens on Friday.
Do your bit. They're doing their bit.
My idea may be a tough sell to Chris, but the tide is turning in our push for volunteers.
You're going to volunteer?
Yeah, I always do volunteer.
Do you?
Yeah,
do you?
Yeah.
If you can drop in on the Friday, that would be brilliant. And any of your friends, you know? V-Day, we need you now to volunteer. Thank you.
I think that's just so excellent.
That would make life simple, wouldn't it? Because it's hard to make plans in advance just to be able to do something on the spur of the moment. If you've got a spare few hours, I think that's a very good way.
Please, V-Day, Volunteer Day, give us your time in the charity shop. Do you want to volunteer?
Oh, yeah.
Will you? Will you really? I need young guys like you. Not only that, Jean's going to take your number.
I think it's a cool thing anyway, because charity shops are kind of becoming a lot cooler now anyway.
You're doing well, ladies, you're doing well.
As the crowd thins out, it's time to count up our new volunteers.
Seven. We've got 60. You've exactly got 60. Oh, and four. 64. 64. We've taken 64 volunteers. Okay, which is amazing, right? Now that we've done that in a couple of hours, I know your feet are killing you. Well done, ladies. I do appreciate it. I really appreciate it. That's 64 we've got in a couple of hours, and we're hoping they turn up at the shops. And when we get these numbers rolling, and people see younger volunteers coming in, I know it will have that knock-on effect. I just know it will.
It's V-Day, crunch time. Will my new volunteers show up? And will this radical new approach be deemed a success?
What will be the real benchmark of whether this works or not is if the managers in the shop don't see it as a pain, but see it as a welcoming support to their shop.
Across London, 20 shops throw open their doors, unsure of who will turn up. I start my day at Mind in West Wickham, meeting sceptical manager Chris, and hoping some great volunteers show up and convert her to my idea.
I'm a bit dubious about what I'm going to find here because I know that Chris and Caroline weren't really behind this. Hi, Chris. Who's your new volunteers?
This is Michael.
Michael, hello. We met on Oxford Street.
Didn't
that's
we
right.
Just? Yeah. We meet at the strangest of places.
Well, what's Chris got you doing?
I'm doing the gift aid forms where people can claim, or we can claim back the tax that people have paid on their income.
Linda. Hi. So what's it been like?
It's been great, yeah. I've been helping out, feeling fulfilled.
And have you ever done anything like this before?
I haven't, but every time I walked into a charity shop, I would want to be, because they always have this really nice atmosphere in there. People are usually really friendly. And I've often thought I'd love to just help out for a little bit. So it's kind of come to pass.
And this works for you, doing it this way, as opposed to just allocating, you know, regular times
exactly.
on regular weeks.
Because you can just choose your times and not have to allocate a regular time.
Oh, that's just amazing.
This is just what I'd hoped for. Surely Chris will be impressed.
Somebody can only commit me an hour a week. I would like to know it was a commitment and that I can have something ready for them to do when they come.
But if you have about 10 people who are drop-in support staff, the chances are, even in the worst-case scenario, if 60% don't turn up, you've got four extra people that can come in the shop and check your scratch CDs.
Yeah, but I don't feel that gives a volunteer enough returns to go home and think, well, I've achieved something today.
My last comment on it. If I'm coming in as a drop-in member of staff, but I'm coming in regularly, surely within that time, like Michael now or someone, we can start training on till, we can start training on pricing. So when they do come in, whether it's for an hour or 2 hours, they can say, right, I'm on pricing today.
No, I price because it's...
You are a control freak.
No, it's just me.
Oh, I price. Am I ever going to convince you?
Try me in 6 weeks, then.
I'll beat you down, you little minx. She still runs a bloody good shop. Go on, get out of the back.
OK, thank you, Mary.
Thank you. She runs a brilliant shop. You know, it's her way. I'm not here to impose on anybody, and this is down to each of the individual charities and each of the individual shops to do it their way. I can only say I think this is a good idea, and I know that there is potential to use it.
I hope other shops aren't as down on the idea as Chris. I'm heading to the North London Hospice shop just in time to see two hunky young men unload a delivery for shop manager Tricia.
I like the way Trish thinks that. Oh, yeah, well, I've got these helpers, so I'll do nothing. That's fun, isn't it? Like, they made them work hard. Us ladies can relax.
Well, we can. It's nice to see some muscle out there. If we just start on one bag, John, and we tip it out, I'll show you. The main thing to look at is obviously around collars.
Yeah, collars and cuffs.
Cuffs, yeah.
Buttons as well.
It's all common sense, really. Yeah. Exactly, John, yeah.
It took them out there a bit long, actually, Trish. A bit long out the back there.
Well, I was showing them all behind the labels and where the rags go.
Right.
Where the recycling... Don't look like that.
Some
some of the managers in the other shops think, oh, it won't work. What would you say to them, having just seen your guys?
I'd say it absolutely does work.
Yeah, yeah.
Because you always need extra help.
Yeah.
You know, whatever business, actually, it's always good to have extra help.
And is it worthwhile for the volunteers?
I think anything that enables people like us who work to get involved in their communities to volunteer is really positive. And I, from what they've said today, it seems to be quite a challenge to get volunteers within charity shops. So anything that can help with that is really good, yeah. I think.
And with people dropping in, you never know what skills they may have. In another shop, a window display trainee is redoing their merchandising.
I mean, the fact that I only had to come here for a few hours is really handy, really, because I don't have to let anyone down by saying, oh, I'll come every week and then not turn up.
And my boys from Oxford Street are hard at it too.
Working here is making me think that maybe I should do some more sort of charity work and stuff, because you look at the people and see how dedicated they are to sort of sorting everything out and they're doing it voluntarily. You kind of think, you know what, maybe I should do something.
64 people promised to volunteer today, and a very respectable 49 turned up. I'm thrilled. I'm ending my day back at my shop in Orpington.
Hi!
They've three fashion students. And there's a new redhead in town.
Hi, how's it been?
It's been really good. I've really enjoyed it.
Have you?
Yeah, it's been so much fun, so I'm definitely coming back. All through the morning
rain, I guess. See, it's fantastic. A bit of youth, Brenda. Yes. A bit of youth.
It is. It's
no, isn't it lovely? Yes.
I feel vindicated. I think drop-in volunteering works and lifts the vibe of the shop.
He likes looking at the young chicks, Brenda.
Well, Brenda's been sitting in windows.
We need some young men for you.
No, can't be bothered.
No.
Don't want young men.
So happy and it feels like an incredible high, you know. They're embracing the new volunteers and they all look happy, you know. They all look happy and enjoying being here, so I feel quite moved by it.
The big question is, do the bosses agree that the V-Day idea works? I ask Head of Retail, Jane.
My concern was how existing volunteers work with new volunteers, and I still think that, you know, that's an issue that we all have to get over. Mm. I think we're on the journey, and I think, you know, as Orpington show, we can do it. We can do it very successfully.
What I want V-Day to be is every day.
Yeah.
You know, not just, you know,
one
a Friday.
Day. Yeah.
So this is the start, and I think, can it work?
We need to make it easier for people to volunteer.
Mm.
And we're always looking at different ways of doing that, but V-Day is a great way of doing that. You're having a go, you're seeing what it's like, you're enjoying it, and hopefully then joining longer term.
So you'll continue to promote it?
Yep, absolutely.
My V-Day.
V-Day.
Be there.
So, after an incredibly rewarding year, my time here is now done.
It's always been
goodbye,
fun.
Goodbye, dear friend.
So good. You're gorgeous. Bye-bye, my darling.
I shall never
You'll
forget
miss
you.
Brenda, won't you?
And I shall never forget you. I'm going to grab my coat and go before I get tearful. Bye.
Okay, then.
Lots of love.
Bye-bye.
Keep it up. Bye, Jane.
Bye,
everyone.
Bye.
Take care. You've done a brilliant job. That is the proudest I've been of any business I've done. From Harvey Nicks to big global clients to all of them, that is the proudest it's made.
You'll not be surprised to hear we're talking election on Newsnight, but you might be interested to learn that our contributors include the novelist Jeanette Winterson and Sir Humphrey Appleby, brought back to life by the creator of Yes Minister.
And before that, on BBC Two, Jeremy Clarkson is the guest host for Have I Got News For You? Next.